Onivia, League of Legends highlights, powered by ArcaneBet.com. Bet live on esports.
Grand entrants have a lot of overlap. Of all champions we see, Rakan can dive and jump in and out of teamfights so often that can dart in. Grand know that he started to enter the blue side jungle, and they also know there were no camps up.
Well, there's the flash from CoreJJ and the flash body slam from Score as well. Ruler, he has to get himself out of there. The slow, the piercing arrow from Dev, and that is going to be first blood, and that is
so... Ambition parking himself here. The mini brush, and that is going to be Cocoon landing. Pawn taking a fair bit of damage as he's looking for it. Gets the double stun, and actually the rest of KT turn up. There's the knock-up, and Ambition is going to be taken down. Score is going to get one on his opposite number. Heroic entry, Crown in trouble, but Smebby's run out of options. Eventually does get it. KT.
What could have been two early Infernal Drakes is an answering one over to KT, and more importantly, some immediate gold onto their members.
Yeah, now Deft is looking for the Chains of Corruption, gets them over the wall. That is just going to lock down Cuve. Deft is going to head back home.
Proper acronym.
We're going to need it. We're going to see a lot of this duo.
Abbreviation, yeah. They're not going to be pursued, but there's the quickness. There's the grand entrance, and Crown taking a lot of damage. But Mata, he's been arrowed off the back end. Ambition, he's taking a lot of damage. And CoreJJ is able to grab the kill. Gets out of the way of the explosive cask as well. As Smeb continues to go aggressive. A double kill now for the Renekton, and this is the carry.
He just moving up the mid lane, trying to get some pressure back here on the map. KT still in relative control. Chains of Corruption go wide. CoreJJ, he's going to be the target. Not enough fancy feet this time around with no flash. He's going to get Justice punched to the face. Antrocute, one up. Samsung, probably unaware that it's going down this fast. There's the flash in. Smeb does get
quickness.
The lockdown. Quickness coming in, and the taunts are there as well. Layering of CC is beautiful on the side of KT as Cuve, he's slowed down. Smeb's on the chase, good flash. Gets Cuve to safety, and KT, they probably just want to turn around. Oh no! If you got a barrel like that, Score, you may as well go in for the kill, and the slice and dice from Smeb closes the gap. He should have the Ruthless Predator, and he does, and that is going to be Cult the Meek to get the grab on.
When you have this much engage like KT does.
Master just battle dances his way out. Score hops over. They're trying to get the kill on the Elise, and they get it! Pawn just still tanking up this Baron as Deft. He's getting taken down incredibly low. Arrow flies forward, but it is going to be avoided. Smeb can just slice his way over this wall. They're committing to this Baron really hard. Crown just needs one Q as Mata, the hero, is going to stand on top of it. That is going to be Ambition, not able to pick up anything because he's dead. And Score grabs the Baron buff. Ruler should die here as well as Heroic Entrance is going to protect the team members of Pawn. CoreJJ, he's going to get killed as well. The bottom lane destroyed. Ambition already dead. Smeb is going to deny that. And there are just kills going down everywhere. The teleport is going to be interrupted by Score, who says, yes, I can answer that. Don't you worry. I have this one. Now just going to get bopped, possibly destroyed. The slow comes down. There it is.
There was some insane... Always keep turning onto the champion, onto the turret. Turns upon turns. Here's the Ash Arrow.
Yeah, arrow comes down. Deft, try and offer some damage back as his support falls. Crown, forced to use the flash. There's the slice and dice, but Smeb can't catch up. Good cocoon from Ambition denies it, but it's still the turrets falling down. Top lane dies as Cuve couldn't even get to it to defend. And Deft is going to sit here, put the arrows required into this inhibitor. Is Pawn going to sacrifice his life, but is he going to be able to grab Ruler? No, he's not. Going to get denied, so 2-0 in favor of Samsung, but KT...
Away from that point, predictably, with Galio and other Snowball targets. Speaking of Snowball...
Whoa, yeah, in goes Mata. They're going to get the Heroic Entrance there as well. Crown is obliterated with no chance of doing anything. Ruler's flashed on by Deft. This aggression from AD carries today has been beautiful to watch. Deft is going to be able to help take down this turret as well, and I can feel KT taking down Samsung in what has been a marathon of a night of LCK summer, but a joy to watch as well.
31 minutes in, knocking on the Nexus. Still Ruler and Crown, all their wayfarer dead for a while. They're looking for more. Here's a dive.
Yeah, that is going to be the stun. The knockback. Score takes down CoreJJ. Cuve for what is attempting the hero play, but can't even get Mata. The Ruthless Predator's there, and Smeb is most certainly that this time around. Cuve Took a long time to die. However, it is still just going to be the last dregs picked up as Ambition is sent to the death chamber. That is going to be the ace for a minute second as the last Nexus turret falls down and KT Rolster continue their massive winning streak after only one fall to Longju Gaming. It's going to be them destroying Samsung in what was a dominant LCK summer beginning.
And the question will still be the same. It doesn't matter what season it is. Can I believe in KT Rolster yet? Can I get excited about KT Rolster and Atlas? It still doesn't feel like we have the clear answer. How they shape up to the Longjus of the world in the second round robin to SK Telecom, that much is not clear. Is this just a blip, an uptick that could be turned around by another losing streak like they had in the spring season? That we don't know. But on this day, the level of macro they showed, there was not many members walking in and dying when they had a lead, which happened again and again and again to comical levels in the spring season. In general, it was an ordered series from KT Rolster. And you can make excuses, you can talk about the blue bar, sorry, the blue side, which was six wins on the day. Getting access to two times on the blue side was a big help to KT Rolster. But by the third game, Samsung weren't in it. KT Rolster should feel good. And this is a big uptick in form for KT, building up to, predictably, that first telecom war.
Exactly.